लास्ट 5 सेकेंड्स, रेडी स्टार्ट। मिस्टर चेयरमैन, आई वुड लाइक टू ऑफर सम रिमार्क्स ऑन दिस इंडस्ट्रियल डिस्प्यूट्स बैंकिंग कंपनीज डिसीजन अमेंडमेंट बिल 1958। एज वी ऑल नो, इन इंडिया सिंस 1939, सिंस द कमेंसमेंट ऑफ द सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर, प्राइजेस ऑफ फूड ग्रेन्स एंड अदर आर्टिकल्स विच आर नेसेसरी फॉर लाइफ आर गोइंग अप एंड अप विद सच स्पीड दैट देर इज़ नो नोइंग वेयर द प्राइजेस विल स्टॉप इंक्रीजिंग। द बेस ईयर 1944 हैज़ बीन टेकन इंटू कंसिडरेशन फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग द बेसिक वेज एंड डियरनेस अलाउंस स्पेशली विद रिगार्ड टू द बैंक एम्प्लॉइज। इवन दैट बेस वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू ड्रीम ऑफ। द प्राइजेज आर गोइंग अप। इन एडिशन टू दिस वी हैव एम्बार्क्ड अपॉन डेवलपमेंटल एक्टिविटीज। द फर्स्ट 5-year प्लान हैज़ बीन ओवर एंड वी आर इन द मिडस्ट ऑफ द सेकेंड 5-year प्लान। वी आर ऑल सर्टेन दैट ए नंबर ऑफ 5-year प्लान्स विल हैव टू बी अंडरटेकन बाई गवर्नमेंट एंड विद द इंक्रीजिंग एक्टिविटीज अंडर ए प्लान प्रोग्राम एंड विद गवर्नमेंट द रेस्टोरिंग टू डेफिसिट फिनांसिंग द प्राइजेज ऑफ आर्टिकल्स विल गो अप and the inflationary tendencies will be there. It is dead certain that the prices of food grains or any article of necessity will never under any circumstances reach the level of 1944. I would like to impress therefore that this dearness allowance, which is meant to be a temporary allowance for a particular purpose to neutralize the cost of living that has gone up because of the rise in prices, has become almost a permanent feature. I therefore urge that this dearness allowance, at least a major portion, should be merged in the basic pay of the employees. It is not only the basic employees of the banking concerns, but the employees of the state governments and the employees of the central government have all along put up this plea that a major portion of the dearness allowance should be merged with the basic pay. By doing that, the employees in the banking concerns as well as the employees in other governmental concerns will be benefited to a large extent, and the government are not going to lose anything at present. They will have to pay either in the form of basic pay or basic pay plus dearness allowance the same amount, but certain benefits that will accrue will be denied. Mr. Justice Gajendra Gadkar, in his report, has stated clearly that a rise in prices will have a greater adverse effect on the lower income groups working in the banks as well as in other government departments. That is why he has evolved a formula that for a particular class of employees, bank employees, a certain proportion or ratio should be calculated in arriving at the dearness allowance. For the category of clerical staff, 1/7 of the basic pay of the bank employees will be raised in the dearness allowance for a rise of every 10 points in the cost of living. What I would like to impress on the government is that the bulk of the employees are there and the cost of living will have great adverse effects on this large chunk of bank employees. This 1/7 that has been allowed under this formula will not be sufficient to neutralize the rise in prices of necessary articles. This question of amending this particular section is there, that every rise or fall of 10 points in the cost of living should within 3 months or quarterly allow the bank or the bank employees to get either a rise or fall in the dearness allowance calculated on the basic pay sanctioned. I therefore urge, sir, that instead of 1/7, 1/5 of the rise should be allowed. If that is done, a large section of the bank employees who are getting less than the minimum wage will be benefited. For the second category of the employees, the subordinate staff, 1/10 of the rise is allowed. Even here, I would urge that it should be increased to 1/7 so that the high cost of living that is going on today will be offset by the rise in the dearness allowance that has been suggested by me. Another point to be taken into consideration is this: the All India Cost of Living Index is not so perfect and is not so reliable. As has been pointed out by the previous speakers on another occasion, the statistical figures that have been supplied to us have been questioned many a time. This cost of living index that has been shown in the governmental register does not really reflect the actual cost of living that is obtaining in particular areas. Many a time cost of living is calculated on the basis of wholesale figures. I would therefore urge that the Labour Ministry should interfere itself in calculating the cost of living index on a more reasonable and realistic basis. Many a time this All India Cost of Living Index is deceptive. Stop.